All right, so we are going to get to a comment submission. So
mailbag!
Mailbag! So this one is from Miguel DeVale. So he had made a comment about the Bills when we posted a video about the wide receiver position. We had mentioned the trading for Amari Cooper might be something that could be on the Bills' radar. The Raiders have clearly no problem getting rid of talented players for nothing. So we had made a comment on how that was something that could be a possibility. And Miguel chimed in and said, you know, that's... that this front office might not make that deal because they seem to value draft picks more than they value known commodities. I think that's a really cool conversation to have.
Absolutely.
So we've seen this team trade known commodities for draft picks. We haven't seen this team trade draft picks for known commodities yet. Right? We haven't seen this organization do it. So is that something that we could expect from the Bills as they have more salary cap in the near future? Or is that something that the Bills just simply aren't going to do? They're going to continue to try and build through the draft. Because truthfully, when you try and build through the draft, that gets very expensive because they're all guaranteed contracts. Anytime you want to cut somebody, that whole thing's dead money. So it can be expensive. You see the Browns doing it now. You saw the Seahawks do it, but the Seahawks went about it a little bit differently. They didn't stockpile draft picks like that.
No.
They just tried to hit in the second, third, fourth, fifth round. They kept trading their first-round draft picks because they were always, you know.
I think once you establish a more consistent winning, that formula is easier to accept as far as the fan base goes, as far as just the business side of it. What's cheaper? Is it cheaper to get a free agent or get a free agent, pay him a lot of money, and it doesn't work out, or draft a guy, give him guaranteed salary, which is a lot lower, and then if it doesn't work out, okay, all right, we only got two more years with this guy. It doesn't matter. I think it boils down to one of those things where do they want someone who's already molded the clay, or do they want to mold the clay themselves in their image? I think that's a great point that's brought up because. It does seem like this organization is like, listen, we're going to be very Green Bay Packer-ish. We want to build from within.
Yeah.
We want to build our maybe one or two free agents, not many, but we want to have a team concept, guys that we mold, the guys that because we don't want guys bringing baggage in. Like, who knows what baggage Cooper has? Albeit a great player. Like, he's just having a bad year.
Right.
But the baggage that he has, what does that come over? Is that worth him trying to spread that around the locker?
Yeah, and there were impact players available, specifically at the wide receiver position.
Yes.
But that come with that baggage. And the Bills aren't interested in any of whatever that is.
They got rid of Darius?
Yeah, they got, exactly. They cleaned
house. Yes.
They cleaned house in that respect. They still have Jerry Hughes. Right?
Yeah.
And Jerry has been known to carry a little bit of baggage, but apparently they're willing to deal with that. But the fact is, you know what? I don't think they would trade a draft pick for a player at this point.
No.
I don't think they're at the point where they're comfortable doing that. I think that is we need to get over the hump, not we need to get to the hump.
You know what? That could have been one of those things where McDermott, when he first met with Pegula before he even got the job, that was the selling point of his. Listen, I've seen the history of the Buffalo Bills. I've seen what's going on over the past 17 years. I know what's been happening. I'm not blind to it. Listen, the Bills have suffered. You guys recycle these coaches that have different philosophies every 3 years. You have these players that are going here and there and everywhere, and then they leave the Bills and become successful. And why? Because they go into a system that works. Give me time to build my team.
Yeah.
I can tell you I can build a winner. I've worked with Andy Reid, who's been successful. I've worked with Ron Rivera, went to the Super Bowl. Listen, let me build my team. If you don't like it, fire me. You can do whatever you want. But let me try to get my guys in here. And the best way to do that is to get young talent that's eager to learn, eager to make the team. And then just go on from there. Listen, I could build up if I get a 22-year-old cornerback that I can mold, that's better than me trading for another guy.
Sure.
If I trade for a guy or I pick up a free agent, it's just going to be a holdover until I get that guy.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So,
yeah, you're absolutely right. Not every player is going to be Leotis McKelvin, who stuck around for like four coaching staffs, or Eric Wood, who stuck around for like five coaching staffs. These things don't happen anymore.
No.
They just don't. So I think that's a great point. You know, I thank you, Miguel, for that comment.
Yeah.
Because I think you're right on cue. You're right on message there. The Bills, when it comes to those draft picks, they're going to find them more valuable to obtain than more valuable to give out in exchange for players. I think they're very comfortable trying to find value free agents, and I don't really see that changing too much. Yeah. So thank you very much for the comment.
Appreciate
thanks again,
Miguel.
Hey, yep. Yeah.